A small regional carrier accepted 21 reservations for a particular flight with 18 seats. 15 reservations went to regular customers who will arrive for the flight. Each of the remaining passengers will arrive for the flight with a 44% chance independently of each other. Find the probability that an overbooking occurs and find the probability that the flight has empty seats. Okay, so what's happening here is the flight has been overbooked, so more reservations have been made than there are seats on the flight. And there's one of two things that can happen. So either someone's going to show up for the flight or they're not, which sort of indicates that we're going to be working with a binomial distribution. And the other parts here that are important, we have a fixed number of trials because there are only a certain number of reservations that were sold. And also we were told that the remaining passengers arrive with a 44% chance, and that's independent of each other. So that probability is not going to change from one to the next. So this is a binomial distribution. That's ultimately what we're going to use to solve this. But let's make sure we understand the question first before we get to that point. So we have a flight with 18 seats. So let me sketch out of, you know, just what that might look like. Okay, so here's my plane. There's 18 seats in this plane. Now, one thing that is important, 15 reservations went to regular customers who will arrive for the flight. So let's just assume that they're already there. So 15 people are already there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So there's that many people already on the plane. That only leaves us these three seats left over. So we have three seats remaining. Now, if 21 reservations were made for the flight, but 15 people have already showed up, that leaves six people left over to show up. Six people remain to show up for the flight. Now, this is where we start seeing the binomial probabilities, because of these six people, there's a 44% chance that any one of these six people will show up. So for this first seat, there's a 44% chance that a person will show up for it, and so forth. Now, if none of these six people show up, that's fine. The plane can take off. There's three empty seats. No big deal. If one person shows up, there's two empty seats. If two people show up, or three people show up, there's still enough room for everybody on the flight. But if four people show up, then an overbooking occurs. That means there's more people than there are seats available. So that's going to be, we're looking for a probability that the number of people who show up for this flight is greater than or equal to four. All right, if that's the case, then we have this overbooking. So we can look at it as at least four people, however you want to word that so that you can know how you're supposed to solve it with a binomial distribution. One way that I do is look at left-right complements. So this is a right-end probability. So the probability that X is greater than or equal to 4 can be converted to a left-end probability. We just make that a less than 4 instead of a less than or equal to, because you can only have the equality on one side. Now, that's not exactly our CDF style function, so we would also need to do one additional change and say this is 1 minus the probability is x is less than or equal to 3. All right, and then that fits us into binomial CDF style probability. So we can now get this by doing 1 minus binom CDF, the number of trials is 6. There's 6 people remaining. The probability that any one person shows up is 0.44, and 3 is our last input. Now, let me get that on the calculator, and I'll do some additional explanation if perhaps you didn't quite follow exactly how I came up with what I did there. So, 1 minus binom CDF, so we need to scroll down till we get to that. And we had 6 trials, probability of success is 0.44, and x is 3. So 0.239. We'll do three decimal places. Oh, I guess the question said four, but that's okay. Three is fine here because it's the principle that matters. All right, now, if you didn't follow what I did here, here's another way of thinking about this. So of the six people, it's possible that none of these people show up, one person shows up, two people show up, three, four, five, or it's possible all six show up. But in this group right here, four or more, this is when an overbooking occurs. So what we want is to add together the probabilities associated with each of these probabilities, each of these outcomes. So the issue is binom CDF will only give you the left-end probability. So the CDF function will only give you the values over here on the left-end. But we can always use a left and right end probability as complementary to one another. So what we can do is we can find this through binom CDF. And then the inputs, of course, would be 6.44 and 3. But because we don't want the left end, we want the right end, we do a complement of that. And that's the same thing that I have written above. So either way you're working with it, that will give you the answer. Now, some of you may be using my online stats calculator, and that is fine as well. Let me show you how that's done. To use it for this question, you would just go under the binomial distributions, set n to be 6. And p, set that to be 0.44. All right, and then what we're looking for is the probability of an overbooking, which would be four or more. And so we'll make sure that the bars associated with four or more are highlighted. And so this sum, the sum of these heights of these bars is the 0.239. All right, now we have another question asking what's the probability that the flight has empty seats? All right, so for it to have empty seats, it would have to have, let's say, at least one empty seat. If it is full, that would be a different question. But it's saying it wants empty seats. So it's possible if one person shows up, there would still be empty seats. If two of those six show up, there still would be empty seats. But if the third person shows up, then that's problematic. So to answer this question, the probability of empty seats is going to be the probability that the number of people who show up is less than or equal to 2. Because if it's 0, there still is all 3 empty seats, 1, there's 2 empty seats, and if 2 people show up, there's 1 empty seat. Now, this is the definition of a CDF-style probability. It's a left end, so we don't need to do any conversions. You really can just do binom CDF, exactly as written, 6.44, and 2 as the last input. So if we do that on the TI, that would look like, let's see here, come up, get the binom CDF function, 6.44, change this to 2, and we come up with 0.462. Okay, and that's our solution. Now, if you happen to be using the online stats calculator from my particular class, another way you can do this is as such. So N and P are not changing, but you just need to think about, like, of all the different outcomes, and you can see along this axis, none of these people could show up, and there would still be 3 empty seats. One person could show up, and there still would be 2 empty seats. Two people could show up, and there still would be 1 empty seat. But if 3 or more show up, then there are no empty seats. All right, so it's either 0, 1, or 2. We just make sure those are highlighted, and this represents the sum of the heights of those bars. So either way you go about it, those should be the answers, and hopefully that helps you solve this problem.